Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. So with the holidays quickly approaching, I thought we would do something holiday-like, like making some kind of a snow effect inside of Fusion. So let's jump over to Fusion and let's start by making it snow. Let's go.
Okay, so here we are with the clip we are going to work with. If you don't want to use your time in Fusion, of course, you could check this video up here where I make a snowflake using overlays, but let's go to the Fusion. So in the effects library, we are going to drag down a Fusion composition and we are going to extend our clip so it will fit with our composition here. And let's go to Fusion. Okay, and in Fusion, we have here our media out. If you want to make sure you're on the right clip, you can click the clips and then you can change if you had more clips in here. Just a little note on that. So I'll just highlight that away again. So let's start by adding a particle emitter, and also we'll add a particle renderer. And then we're just going to connect that to our media out. And then I'm just going to highlight the emitter here. And as you see, if we actually already now have the particles here, but we can't see them because they are not filling up the whole screen. So the reason or the way we'll do this is just to take this circle and then direct that so it will fill the screen. And if we take a look at that now, we have some particles. So first off, let's go down here and right click and then add a tool. And I want to go into particles and I want to add a turbulence, which is down here somewhere. Like so. So now I have a particle turbulence added as well. And then with the emitter selected, I can now change the lifespan if I wanted to. So I can then increase or decrease to make the snow life a little bit longer or shorter. And then of course we also have the numbers of snow coming in. We can do that here. And then we can do a variation of the numbers so they will not be the same, they'll be like different places. So now we have that like so. Go into the style of this, and in the style we can change the style from point into blob, for instance. So that will help a little bit, but we can also use brush, and then we can just change the brush to a flake. So the one thing about this actually is that this will be a little heavy on the processor, as you can see. For this first thing we'll do with the snow, as you see here, it'll take a long time to render. So we'll change the style again and we'll use blob instead. As you see, this is much, much easier for the processor in your computer. Okay, so we'll go back here, and then in velocity, we are going to boost that up quite a bit because we want the snow to go from the top to the bottom. So also we can change the variant on that, and here we can change the angle of the snow. So if we wanted it to go from top to bottom, we would change it to like a negative 90 degrees, but I don't want to do that. I want to do something a little bit different. So I want it to go like more from the side in because of the clip. Let's say we want to do something like that. That's good. So let's go into the turbulence. And there in the turbulence, we can change how. So if we bump up this, we can make it snow like very much more. So that is the tempo of the strength of the turbulence. and we can, you can customize this as you want. I'm just going to bump it up a bit. I'm not going to do too much though. And let's just have a look at what we have for now. So you see, we have some small snow things. And the one thing we don't like here is that I want this to be like background snow. So I actually want to make a little trick here to isolate me from the snow so I don't get snow from the background on me. And we're just going to push Alt. But before we do that, we're going to take off the link. So we'll only drag that. So Alt drag, and we have now copy pasted one clip, or duplicated that. And then we'll put that up on video layer 3. And as you see now, all the snow are gone. We're going to fix that in the color tab, of course. So with the top layer selected, you can also watch here in the corner, we have a V3 here, which tells us that this is the third video layer. So with that selected, we are going to make a quick mask selection. So here we are just going to, I'm going to make just a quick mask around myself here. And of course you can do a mask job way better than me, but I'm just doing this super fast for the sake of this tutorial. So this is just a basic idea of how to do it. Like so. I really could do a better masking than this, but anyways, let's just get on with it. Like so. Let's finish up the mask here. Yeah. And like so. And then we are just going to put a little bit inside and some outside and then soften it just a tad. That's what we do. So let's go into our tracker and then push frame. And then I'm just going to push in a keyframe. And I'm just going to do this manually as fast as I can because it's a super short clip and I like to do the mask like this. Anyway, the tracker is quite good, but sometimes it gets a little little strange. So I'll just do it super quickly here. So I'll just go back in time, move this so we'll be at the right spot. Like so. Okay, so let's see if that's okay. Again, the tracking of this could be better, but we'll just do some small corrections. Again, you can use way more time on this and make it look better than what I'm doing. This is just the basic anyway. Let's see if we're going to little correction here. Like so. Okay, I think that is not good enough, but that's how it's going to be. That is actually a pretty bad pantomime I'm doing there, by the way. I just realized that. But anyway, we are going to right-click, and then we're going to do a alpha out, and we're going to connect that here. So now we are only seeing the selected mask we did. So that means when we are walking now here, we can see that the snow is falling behind us. And we are going to give the snow a little bit more later on, I think. So the second thing we need to do is we are just going to, again, Alt-drag, and we're going to copy our fusion composition and putting that on top here. And then, as you see now, the snow is again, it's snowing in front of us, and we are going to change the look of that snow right now. So again, let's just make sure we're on the right clip. Yes, we are. And then we'll just close down the clips again. And let's go back to the emitter here. And let's go into random seeds here. We're just going to put a little bit of randomness into it. It's not too much, just a little bit. And let's see. Yeah, that's good. Okay. Then we're going to go here to the style. And we're going to change it from blob into brush, because this is the front snow. So we want to use some kind of a flake. Let me just zoom in a bit here so we can see how our snowflakes look. And we can then change them if we wanted to some of the other ones. Most likely that is a little too funny looking, a little too cartoony for my sake. So we'll change that back to a different one. Also, that is a little too cartoony. Let's go for this one with the C. Let's just, again, looks pretty nice. Let's just zoom in a bit and see how the flakes look. Yeah, something like that. And now we have snow flakes falling in the foreground. But we will need to do something more, I think. Okay, we'll go again back here, and then I'm going to boost up the velocity again, and then the variation of that, we're going to change that a bit. Again, this is all, there's no right way of doing this. This is just trial and error to make it look like you want it to, because it's, that's just the way it is. So let's have a look at how that look now. So now we have snow in the beginning, and as you see, this is pretty intensive on your computer when you're using the brush tool instead of the blob. But we still need to change something, so back to Fusion. Okay, so we're going to go to the renderer, and in the renderer we are going to add in a little bit of blur to our snowflakes. Not that much, because then it'll be all invisible. Just a little bit. And again, this is, again, totally up to how you want your snow to look. Just a little bit of blur, not too much. So now it is a little more blurred in the beginning. We have to do a little trick more, I do believe, to make this look better. Okay, in Fusion, we are going to the emitter, and we're going to the style. And then we are going into the size control, and we are just going to bump up the size of our snowflake. Okay. Like so. And then we'll go to the first layer of snow we have. And we're just going to, again, go into our emitter. And then we're going into the style, and we are going to take the size, and we are going to make that a little bit bigger as well, so that the snow in the background will be a little bit larger as well. Something like so. Okay. So let's have a look at that. Okay, and as you might notice from this clip here, it does take a little time for the snow actually to begin. It is like it has a beginning, and maybe we don't want that. Maybe we want the snow to be there from the beginning already. So let's fix that fast as well. Go into Fusion, and let's go to the first clip here. And we go into this one, the pre-generated frames, and we're going to put this to around 24 frames. So that will be like 1 second, the animation will begin 1 second earlier. And then we'll go to the second clip, and then we'll go into the renderer. And for the other clip, we'll do the exact same thing. We'll go into the renderer, and then we'll go down to pre-generated frames, and we'll put that at 24 frames yet again, so the snow will already be a second, or will be beginning a second before, since I am shooting 24 frames a second. So here we have the final result. We're walking in the snow, and then this is just the beginning point, because then we could kind of do whatever we want. So I'll just tweak the settings a bit and we'll end up with something looking like this. So on this clip, I just tweaked the snow just a bit. It doesn't look like realistic snow, but of course you could make it look like that by tweaking all of the settings I just showed you. Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it will help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on the channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.